This is the second tech video in the Range Visitor Management 5.0 how-to videos. In the previous video we learned how to configure and install visitor management. In that video we saw that the general manager of Rojo Security, Charles Smith, has appointed himself as VM admin. And as such is responsible for the configuration and testing of the visitor management application. The visitor management web application listens to port 5706. And the dashboard is available on the main page. Charles is the VM admin, and therefore able to change all the settings. He navigates to the general settings of visitor management. The super graphic option will place a colorful bar on top of our web page. The logo can be modified. The size, however, is restricted. 125 by 63 pixels. To supply legal information to our customers, we have the option to present our non-disclosure agreement. And a document that describes the terms and conditions of the Rojo company. To accommodate our international clientele, we want to offer the application in different languages. To communicate the details of the visit between our employees and customers, we need a mail server. Therefore, we will configure our internal SMTP server. Sukiyo is the contact person between Rojo and its customers. Hence, she is the one who is listed as the sender on the messages. Charles wants to check if everything is configured correctly and sends himself a message. That test mail tells us that the mail server is configured correctly. Now that we have checked that the mail functions correctly, let's see what there is to mail. That brings us to email templates area. There are four different templates. The first two are intended to be used in conjunction with mobile access. The third one is the most interesting template. That is the template that generates the invitation mail to our guests. There is information that is automatically loaded from the system. That are the fields between the double curly brackets. The information between the square brackets, however, is meant to be modified manually, according to the specific company needs. This is the other template of interest. On visitor arrival, it will send a mail to the host. Files can be found in the folder C. Program Files x86, Bosch Sicherheitssystemen, Bosch Visitor Management, Client App, Public, Static Files. Of course you can edit the files directly. But it is more obvious to make copies first and then edit them. Charles decides to copy the two most important ones. Visitor Invite. And inform host about check-in. We will open the HTML with Notepad++. With that editor we can read and edit the HTML file smoothly. The HTML coding is blue, the parameters are red and the static text is black. That's where we need the modifications. Let's first adapt the body of the mail to the needs of Rojo Security. The footer is equal on all four templates, so we only need to modify it once and then copy it over to the other three. For now, Charles is happy with the modifications. Let's save it and modify the other one accordingly. With the visitor invite template, we can inform the visitor about the planned visit. The footer is easy. That is just a copy of the other template that we modified before. Now we like to see the result of our modifications. Inform host about visitor arrival at Roho office. And visitor invite to Roho security. So far, so good. Now let's return to the web application and enable the modified templates. Sukiya will always receive a copy of all outgoing mail. She must be informed on all visitor-related correspondence. For the time being, Charles also wants a copy, so that he can follow whether everything is going as expected, and for now he wants to test it. Now that Charles has registered himself for the test mails, he likes to see the results of his modifications in his mailbox. This test mail is for the visitor invite. Charles is happy with the result. This one is the visitor arrival message for the host. The footer also contains a link to a document on the GDPR regulations. Very important in the European Union. That is why Charles also wants to test this. To complete the visitor workflow, Charles needs to configure a few more settings. Inform visitor about the visit by mail. And inform host when the visitor checks in for this visit. As well the receptionist as the host should be able to send these mails automatically. Charles also wants that the hosts can set the noted departure. That can differ from the expected departure or checkout time. Now let's see the results of our configuration. Gianna has planned a visit with her contact of the company De Bruyne Group. Gianna has been assigned the VM host role. And therefore she has the credentials to log on to visitor management. She can register her own visits by clicking the big blue plus icon. She knows her visitor and her visitor ID. That was assigned already during a previous visit. It is Miss Vilika Lizalota De Bruyne. She is the CEO of the Bruyne Group. A visit is planned for tomorrow 9 o'clock. And will last for approximately 1 hour. And take place in Office 3. Gianna wants to be informed when her guest checks in, and also wants that she receives an invitation by email. That will most likely succeed because the email address is included in the customer profile. The current status is expected. Tomorrow Vilika is expected to check in. The invitation is well received by Vilika. Sukiya is the office manager of Roho Security, and also the primary contact person and receptionist for all visitors. Her role in visitor management is VM receptionist. This gives her the opportunity, among other things, to approve the visits and to assign the badges. When she logs on, she sees on her dashboard that for today there is visit planned at 9 a.m. Vilika enters the Roho office at the expected time and introduces herself at the reception. Sukiya checks the details and asks the guest to confirm. Sukiya will guide Vilika to Office 3. The visit can be approved. And the visitor will be assigned one of the 5 cards, recently prepared for the guests by Charles Smith. Now that the visit has been approved, an email is sent to the host about the visitor's arrival. Gianna checks her mail and prepares for the visit. Time flew by. And in the end, the very successful meeting lasted no less than 140 minutes. Gianna thought it necessary to mention that in the visit report. After Villica left her office, Gianna once again opens the visitor management application. She notes that in the dashboard the status has indeed changed to overdue. In the noted departure field, she can enter the real end time, which is quite different from the expected departure time. A bit longer is rather modest. When Villica reports to reception and returns her badge, Sukiyo can take it back and return it to the system by deassigning. Villica has left and the badge is available again for the next guest. This concludes the second tech video in the Visitor Management 5.0 series. This time the emphasis was on the configuration and its impact on the different users. In particular, we have seen how we can use the mail function to streamline communication between our own staff and customers. In the next video of this series, we will show you how mobile access will find a place in the further optimization of visitor management.